If you want to change the way you're taking notes in the year 2025, this is what you need. Google Notebook LM. The experiment tag was off in October 24, and since then, geez, it's just getting crazier and crazier. No wonder it's virality with so many videos and articles flooding the net. Me included. So in this video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about Google Notebook LM and how to use it, with 5 relevant use cases and various examples so that you can start documenting your notes smartly, or learning, or studying, or doing research, or doing your journaling, or whatever else smartly. I'll also show you how to combine its usage with GPT to make your workflow even more powerful. Google Notebook is probably the best way of saving notes using AI. Heck, it's got such a dope UI and so intuitive to use, almost takes me back to when Figma had just hit the scene. So do watch this video in this newest series on my channel that shows you how to get started with Google Notebook LM and how you can use it to boost the crap out of your productivity in Darkness. Alright, so let's check out this bomb of a drop by Google that's gonna change how we take notes in the future, right? Your personalized AI research assistant, just upload your sources and it'll give you insightful insights, something that we'll see down the line along with all the use cases like I just described, right? As the folks at Google Labs put it, it's gonna help you with power studying, organizing your thinking, and sparking new ideas. And I'm gonna show you through the course of this video with all these different use cases, how exactly each of those things can so easily happen for you as well. Right, so enough chatter, let's try Notebook LM. Let me just show you really quickly, right? When you create your notebook, what exactly you're expected to do, how you go about it. Right, so you can upload your sources, which could be either Google Drive links if they're internal, it could be something that you can upload like a PDF, links online, whether it's websites or YouTube links, or even text that you want to copy paste from an article or a blog or something. And really quickly, when you put these in, let me show you an example of all these various links. This is a little bit of research I was doing on the Gutenberg-Richter equation, you know, for a quick script on earthquakes or whatnot, right? So I've shared a link from Wikipedia. I've shared another source that I found online, a PDF that I thought was useful, and a little bit of information that I got from GPT as well. And this is just to show you how you can upload all these various different sources that we have accumulated with whatever research that we have done in the time spent surfing the net. And as soon as you put it together, now with all these sources combined, you can start asking questions to Notebook LM, and it's just going to blow your mind, folks, because this is exactly how we're going to make notes and do our research and do our studying as we go forward, right? I can't imagine how this would have been in 2011, 2012 when I was struggling with my mechanical engineering textbooks and whatnot. But as you can see here, question asked, very clearly answers pointed out with citations from where exactly they got the content from the source that validates what exactly is being said, right? And you can ask your questions, as you can see here. Explain the formula clearly and give information on its history. You know, just to see if that kind of information was actually called out in the sources I've given. And if so, if it can present the same to me. And there are various formats that you can also extract out of it depending on how you want to consume the content, right? In terms of a study guide or an FAQ set, you know, with 8-10 questions that can be extracted for this particular concept. Like you can see a study guide very clearly with all the points and all the various things that need to be kept in mind as a student, clearly put together, right? You could also export it in the form of an audio that's going to do something very crazy, which I'm pretty sure you've already seen online, but I'll save that for a use case that we'll see up ahead. Right, so as you may have guessed, there are so many different things that you can do with something like this, right? Now, let me show you another where very quickly, if I upload a report like this, you know, for some research that I was doing about the edtech sector a couple years ago, and putting that in there, getting a real quick summary like this is very easily going to give me some points that I can use to make a deck of sorts, right? In fact, if you're the kind who hates reading and would prefer listening to something, or for that matter, if you're in Bangalore or Mumbai or Delhi or any of these cities that has absurd levels of traffic and all you want to do to kill time is to listen to a podcast or something, hit generate on any of your reports, so to say, and what you get is a podcast like this.
All right, so, you know, we've got all this research on the ed tech market.
Yeah.
And sometimes it feels like it's just a bunch of buzzwords.
Right.
Like, are we really getting down to what matters?
Yeah.
You want to know what's really going on?
It's interesting because, you know, there's a lot of noise out there.
Yeah.
But this report, it's not just about how big the market is.
Yeah.
And there's so much you can do with this kind of output, right? At the end of the day, if it's news, for example, that you want to put out there in the form of a faceless YouTube channel, for example, right? Get the podcast out like this, break it into the two voiceovers that you already have very clearly in this conversational form, feed it into a tool like this, like Hey Jen, where you can create an avatar and make like a news channel set. And you have a bunch of videos out there. So the use cases of putting content out there extracted from something like this is just something else altogether, right? And it's just absolutely so fascinating. I've actually been exploring a little bit with an AI avatar of myself. You'll probably see him in some of the videos up ahead. Let me know in the comment section if and when you spot the guy. But coming back to NotebookLM, right? Like I said, now that we have a summary that we've very easily been able to extract from the report, if you have to make a pitch deck or something like this, present it to a superior or a boss who wants, you know, real quick notes, what can you do with this? You have these quick pointers. You can, to some extent, probably probe it a little bit more, get it into finer bullets that you can use later, and then feed it into a tool like, say, Napkin AI that can very easily make a quick diagram for you for each of these sections that you can then put onto your deck. I plan to make an extensive deep dive into how to use Napkin AI, a video which you should see in the series very soon. Because that's what I do on this channel, right? Try and figure out the best ways to get you creatively hustling, whether that's incorporating some processes or pipelines or some hacks that I've learned across the years doing all the things that I have, or even if it's tools like this that can just help you streamline your process, get better at what you do and become a far better designer or creator or manager or whatever you are in whatever discipline you work. These tools are for us to adopt and get better at what we do. And if there's any way by which I can bring that out to you and help you adopt these, then job well done at my part, I guess. So be sure to check out a couple of these videos, whether it's to make your package designs on Packdora or to get your architect juices flowing with Minimal or Wizcom. To make content for my YouTube channel, by the way, of course, there's a lot of research that I need to do. And to some extent, figuring out what other people in my space are doing, what's kind of trending, what's not, what's working, something that I got to constantly look at. And again, to do stuff like that, using a tool like NotebookLM is exactly how one needs to go about it, right? So very quickly, for example, some explorations that I've been doing with respect to AI animations and this phenomenal video by Futurepedia, a massive fan, of course, of the content that he puts out, very clearly calls this out, you know, in this epic video with like 10 animation tools that we should all explore, right? So really quickly putting that link straight into NotebookLM and figuring out what exactly I can extract out of this for my content at some point, whether it's one tool specifically that I want to create, whether it's something else, if it's some research that I want to do, get some notes out from here that I can then put into my video, for example. And then yeah, asking the questions and very clearly breaks down all the tools that you know being talked about in the video. It can give you a proper run through into each of these tools if, of course, that's what was done in the video. And that's the best part about NotebookLM, right? It's going to make sure that it limits itself to whatever content and sources provided to it rather than hallucinate and create and fill the gaps that it believes exists. So as you can see, something specific like write me a 5-page manual on how to use Minimax in a proper guide format, for example, right? And another use case where putting a video in there, getting a quick write-up of what exactly it's out about, whether it's an installation guide that you want to make, whether it's some document or a flyer poster or something that you need to create as an extension to the video format, getting it out in a manner as seconds, it's absolutely crazy. So if you further click on the source, for example, it gives you a proper breakdown of what exactly is there in this particular video. So all that information that actually exists, I'm trying to extract some nuances that weren't specifically the front line of the document, right? But it can still read that and find that out for you and provide you the same. And yeah, if you thought that was crazy, imagine using a tool like NotebookLM in tandem with another powerful tool like, say, GPT, right? And check this out. Not going to spend too much time here because I've given you a pretty good look at how you can use this tool. But another use case, right? A couple decks that I really quickly put in as sources of some competitor analysis I've done of other YouTube channels and just trying to figure out if there's content that I want to create as per a strategy that I've put in place. What exactly is the content that I should create, right? Based on what others are doing. So a lot of research really quickly done, put it into a PDF, given a little bit of my marketing strategy that I have in mind in terms of the kind of content, topics or reels that I want to create. fed that into NotebookLM, and there you go, asking it some questions like figuring out one key topic that's going to work for each of these sections or each of these subjects that I want to talk about. And on further probing, when you get your final list of 5-10 topics that you think work, just feed that into GPT, because at the end of the day, the script writing work isn't really NotebookLM's as much as it is GPT's, right? And sharing this, whatever content you've gotten from one form, which has distilled all your sources, very clearly identified the points to bring on screen, and then kind of putting that into GPT for a creative layer, can just show you the output. And, you know, with just about 5-10 minutes of back and forth with GPT, I had 100 content scripts, which are all very, very, very good, with high chances of virality if put right and executed the right way. So there you have it, NotebookLM. If this isn't how you're going to be creating your content or making your notes or doing your research, then you're missing out on an edge that everybody else is going to have on you. I hope you found this video useful and liked it. If so, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Peace out. I'll see you in the next one.